हेलो शिल्पा मैम,
हेलो शिल्पा।
गुड इवनिंग सर। आवाज आ रहा है सर?
यस मैम, यू आर ऑडिबल। आई एम शेयरिंग दिस।
हाँ, ऑल ऑफ अ सडन लाइट हैज गॉन, सो हाँ थिंग्स चेंज, बट नो मैटर, वी विल स्टार्ट। सो वेलकम एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर ऑन द डे 5th ऑफ महाटीटी क्रैश कोर्स। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द अर्वी फाउंडेशन, I am really honored to have this workshop and guide student teachers. So I will be thanking Nayan sir for taking initiative for all teachers, which will help student teachers to honor the exam and upgrade themselves for the exam. Now again, as third time, the CET has CET exam has postponed to 21 November. We have enough time now. Whatever we learn today, we can go through it. So, shall I start, Abhishek sir?
Yes, ma'am. We can start.
Okay. So, next slide, sir. I have divided today's session in half hour. For science, half hour, then physics, half hour, and geography, half hour. So we will be, discussing question answers and with multiple choice answers. So you get the idea of how to answer or, a practice of, within the time limit, how we should get the correct answers. So let's start with the topic science content. So 21 November, the final date has come yesterday's GR is 21 November. Timetable will be, timing of exam will be same, just date has postponed to 21 November. Good evening to all. We shall start the science subject. I will just go through the topic first. And some slides first, then we will go for our practice discussion. The first topic is about food, source of food, components of food, cleaning of food, means how from field land to our plate, how food comes, or what processes it goes through. Next is materials used in daily life. Next is world of the living. Habitat, we have, how we live, and we will go through the questions, practice questions also. The abiotic component, that is air, water, and soil, we will learn in deep. Next is plant kingdom, here are the subtopics. Animal kingdom, here are the subtopics. the next life. Yes. How things work in a matter like electric color, current and circuit. Next topic is magnetism, which is very also important. And these are the subtopics. Next is natural phenomena like change of state, then freezing, melting. We have evaporation, condensation, and water cycle. Now, natural resources again, we have here renewable sources and non-renewable resources. So before going for practice questions, I want some slides to share with, because I think these tables you should know. So next slide. Here is the lifespan of each animals. I think if any question regarding this question, regarding this lifespan comes, you are able to answer it properly. So please go through this slide. We have science for 1 hour only, half hour only. So we will quickly go for the next slide. Here is the next slide, which is on the air proportion, the gases in the air proportion. So you should also learn technically the figures and facts, so because you have to answer it incorrect. Next slide, sir. Here is the plant kingdom, the subfolders of plant kingdom. So I will just practice these questions in question answer session. If you have taken a screenshot, then it will be good to go for another slide for animal kingdom. Yes, sir, we can move on. Here is the animal slide, cellular structure, vertebral.
Sorry, teachers, I think Shilpa ma'am has some technical problem. We will be back in 2 minutes.
So next slide. We can move on next slide. Here are the properties of substances. Water, glass, chalk. We can go through in the end, every slide we can go through. I think we have to know about this slide, because maybe it can come paper one, but let it be for paper two, it is considered very much. Next is sugar and salt. Next slide. Yes, sir, milk. Here is the adult ration. How things are mispropered and bring in market with this thing. So we have to learn this, like milk powder, water is used, chemicals like urea starch is mixed in milk. Now chili powder, brick powder is mixed, powder pumpkin is mixed, peppercorns, papaya seeds are mixed, ice cream, washing soda, paper pulp is mixed, rice, small white stones are mixed, and peanuts, radish, pebbles are mixed. So if question related to this come, please be assured that you take the correct answer. Next, sir. So here are the, you know, balanced diet food, the first topic we are going to learn. So here is the details of what are their resources, what is their function in our body, and if we are not taking in proper amount, what deficiency disease we can have. So these things are very figured, and to the point we have to learn it. Yes, sir. Next slide is very important, same as here, yeah, because we are discussing about vitamins. Yes, sir. Next slide. So here is a list of vitamin A, B, C, D, E, K. One or maximum two questions are asked from this, this unit. So better we learn and get the full marks there. So if two questions are there, we should get 2 marks there because we have read this question. I will not discuss this because I want to discuss in question papers. Yes, sir. Next slide, we can move on. Here is the nutrition and diet again in details. If you can go to... So like nutrition, carbohydrate, proteins, vitamins, and fiber, again, their sources and functions in our body. So same as mineral and vitamins also in a short form. Yes, sir. This is related to that only because, yes, it was a lengthy one. So I adjusted here only. Okay, this is the slide of planets of solar system. So what is the number of satellites they have? What is the rotation period? Because it has to be, you know, there are only, we have our 8 planets only now. So we have to be very particular about this, their atmosphere, their number of things, their number of days of rotation. Very important slide for this question, this topic. Yes, sir, we can go ahead. This is the last slide about metals and metals and metallites. Their properties, their physical properties, their chemical properties. If you learn in this way, things get faster. How we learn faster is divide and rule. Just topic or subtopic, then subtopic or again topic. If you make a story or if you make a mind map of any topic, it is learned faster. And we get, you know, structured learning. And that is what brain remembers a long. So it is saved in long-term memory. So for this, we have to have some triggered words to learn it deeply. So I want Abhishek sir to go on first slide only, the title of this science topic. So one by one, I will just go through the topics, and we shall have question answers this session starting from the first chapter. So we have only 15 minutes left now for science. Let's go through it. So question answers I am discussing orally. So guys, as we have practiced the answers in chat box, I am waiting for it. So for the food, we have different types of food. We have food habits of different animals, like some are herbivorous, some are carnivorous, some are scavengers, some are parasites. Parasites are the animals which live on another animal, within that animal. So we have to understand their definitions also. Comes the components of food. We have to detail. I have given the table also. Let's go for the question answer session. Here comes our first question. The fruit of this plant are used as spices in food. Name the plant. Onion, ginger, chili, brinjal. The fruit of this plant are used as spices in the food. Name the plant. Onion, ginger, chili, brinjal. Yes, you can either you can write this full answer, or it, if it is okay with you, you can write A, B, C, D also. So we have a you know, within a time we can answer this. Yes, chili is the correct answer. Now, human beings are herbivorous, carnivorous, C, both, A and B, D, none of the above. A, herbivorous, carnivorous, both A and B, none of the above. Yes, the correct answer is C, both herbivorous and carnivorous. Next, name the plant whose leaves are used as vegetables. Yesterday also I asked, mustard, brinjal, potato, banana. Yes, mustard is the correct answer. The food of butterflies. The food of butterflies is sprouted seeds, blood of the other animals, small insects, nectar. The food of butterflies, sprouted seeds, blood of the other animals, small insects, nectar. Right, nectar is the correct answer. D option is the correct answer. Very good. I will ask two more questions from this section. White of an egg turned violet when two drops of copper sulfate and 10 drops of caustic soda is added to it. This indicates that the presence of dash protein, starch, vitamins, fats. Protein, very good. Correct one. So next one and last one is here. It is glands in the neck become swollen in the disease. Which disease, no? One, A, goiter, B, beriberi, C, rickets, D, scurvy. Yes, the correct answer is A. Thank you, everyone. Let's move to the next topic, materials. So materials in the of daily life, like fibers we use, types of fibers are like cotton, silk, wool, polyester, nylon, rayon, acrylic, and jute. We have to learn detail about this fibers. Now uses of fibers also we have to learn. Let's go through the question answers directly. Which of the following is obtained from the hair of an animal? Silk, nylon, cotton, wool.
Okay, this is some technical term, but I want you to understand this. Each ball contains about dash of cotton. Each ball contains about dash of cotton. Means how many seeds? So A, 30 seeds and up to 6 lakh fibers, 30 seeds and up to 5 lakh fibers, 20 seeds and up to 5 lakh fibers, 60 seeds and up to 8 lakh fibers. So this is very technical, but if come, we should answer it. So correct answer is B. Please, if you have a pen and pencil, write it down. The correct answer is B, 30 seeds and up to 5 lakh fibers. Each ball contains about dash of cotton, that is 30 seeds and up to 5 lakh fibers. Let's go to next question. The main dash steps involved in making fabric and fiber are A, 4 steps, B, 3 steps, C, 5 steps, D, 6 steps. Four steps are correct. Very good. So what are the four steps here? Is ginning, combing, spinning and weaving. Okay, these are the four steps. Now, jute plants are widely grown up in which state? MP, UP, Bengal, Gujarat. Jute plant. Yes, right. See, Bengal. So next comes our topic, world of living. Here we have to learn about living things. Living things need food and water. We can differentiate here about living thing and non-living thing. As they grow, living things grow. Living things have definite life of span. I have given you life, a lifespan of animals, different animals. Now animals can move. All living things respire to get energy. And how energy chemically? There is a chemical reaction given in a book. I will share the textbook links, which is freely available on site at the end of our session. Next is excretion process also. And last two things are very important. Living things respond to stimuli and living things reproduce. Let's go for the, we have to learn their habitat, like which are the habitat, desert habitat, grassland habitat, rainforest habitat, tundra habitat, mountain habitat. So, where we live, what is the environment also defines the living style of living life of living things. Like where is heavy rainfall, we have different, life structure or lifespan. And where ice is the temperature is very low, there is a very different life environment also. So next comes our abiotic component, like in air, in water, uses of air, uses of water. Next comes our soil. So we have to go through details of soils also. In each textbook also, we have grading is upgraded, as class is upgraded, we have level up topics according to them. Now, let's go for the question answers here. So I am including here plant kingdom also, animal kingdom also in this area. So I can take here 3 minutes question answer session. Who among the following developed the concept of phenology? Hippocrates, Ernest Haeckel, Linnaeus, Lamarck. I think this is very important. So I have taken this first question. Yes, Ernest Haeckel. B option is correct. Okay, who is the father of taxonomy? Tell me. Parasser A, B, Theophrastus, C, Linnaeus, D, Darwin. Father of taxonomy. Very good. Thank you, everyone. C is the correct answer here. Now, here comes our next question. In terms of fertilization, does not involve fertilization, does not involve one, acrogynia, B, water, C, pollen tube, D, phlegeted anthrozoals. Anthrozoals. Yes, pollen tube. Very good. So I will get the next question here. Eye spot is found in the plant body of dash. Ulva, Spirogyra, Ulothrix, Chemicomanus. Yes, D option is the correct answer. Now, next question is plastids develop from dash. Huh? This is the animal cell or plant cell. You have to go through this. Proplastid, nucleus, cell wall, vacuole. Yes, preplastid. Okay, A option is the correct answer. So let's go for the next topic here. Motions, we have a measurement standard unit. This is the chapter where we measure our distance and moving things again. So measure, what is measurement? What is SI unit? What is the measurement of lengths? Their unit, their definition, what is rotatory motion, oscillatory motion, vibratory motion, you have to go through definitions. So I will just ask question from this. Yes. 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 centimeter, 100 meter, 10 meter, 10,000 meter. 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 centimeter. -centimeter. 1,000 centimeter. A, B is 100 centimeter. C is 10 centimeter. D is 10,000 meter. So 1 kilometer is 1,000 centimeter. Yes, easy one, but don't. There we 1,000 centimeter. Okay, 1,000 centimeter. 1 kilometer is K means 1,000. Keep in mind, you know, simple questions, but we just get confused why they will give easy answers. So like that. Now, next is standard unit of length in SI system is cubic centimeter meter span. Standard unit of length is? Yes, meter. Very good. Which of these is translatory motion? A, rectilinear motion. B, curvilinear motion. C, random motion. D, all of the above. Which of these is translatory motion? Rectilinear motion, curvilinear motion, random motion, all of the above. Yes, A answer is correct, ma'am. Rectilinear motion. The slope of time velocity graph represents A, force action on the body, B, momentum of the body, C, acceleration of the body, D, displacement of the body. Acceleration of the body. Okay. The slope of time velocity represent acceleration of the body is the correct answer. Okay. See. So if you don't have, history is also important. Let's go to the next topic. How things work. Electric, here are the, sir, next slide. Abhishek, sir. Yes. How things work, electric current and circuits, like electricity is form of energy widely and used by man. And then electric cell converts chemical energy into electric energy. Circuits we will go through if question comes. The path of the electricity is called dash, filament, orbit, circuit, none of the above. Circuit, very good. C is the correct answer. Circuit. The path of electricity is called circuit. Which of the following does not belong to the group formed by the others? First one is steel, A steel, B glass, C iron, and D tin. Yes, B is the answer, glass. Thank you. Very good going. Yes. Next question is, the main function of the switch is to complete or break a circuit, make the bulb glow easily, C, allow charges to flow, prevent electric shocks. The main function of a switch is complete or break a circuit. Very good. Now, last question from this chapter, I think. Which of the following energy conversions take place in a torch? A, chemical electrical light, B, electrical chemical light, C, light chemical electrical, D, electrical light chemical. What is the process? So, shall I repeat again? Which of the following energy conversions take place? Chemical in a torch, chemical electrical light. Yes, correct answer you all have given. A is the correct answer. It is chemical energy first change into electricity, and electrical energy is change into light. Very good. Now comes our next chapter. Natural phenomena. Here we learn about the different states of water. Their change of states like solid, liquid, and gas. Solid is ice, liquid is water itself, and air is moisturizer. So how it changes from one state to another? So we have freezing, we have melting, we have evaporation, we have condensation, and again all this processes in water cycle also. So lightning with and thunder, lightning and conductor. Okay, if I would allow here 2-3 topics, points I have to make you understand. Sounds travel slower than light. So sound travels slower than light. This is very important, I think. And changing of water vapor into liquid. What is that called? A, evaporation, B, melting, C, freezing, D, condensation. Yes, correct answer, condensation. Let's go for another question. Water exists in how many states? 3, 5, 6, 2. Water exists in? Yes. Option A is 3, B is 6, C is 5, and D is 2. So option A is correct. That is 3 answer is correct. So water exists in 3 states. Yes, this is easy one, but sometimes when it is given, we just, confuse what to answer. Now, ice has a definite shape, size, both A and B, shape and size, none of the above. Ice has a definite shape, size, both A and B, none of the above. Both A and B, very good. So here comes our natural resources. Natural resources, we know, renewable resources, which can be renewed. And non-renewable sources, once the stocks are exhausted, it may take time of thousands of years to renew. So we can say at least for our life generation, we should use less non-renewable sources. Two more resources they have explained that I will tell you here. One is actual resources and second is potential resources. So what are they? Actual resources are those resources whose quantity is known. These resources are being used in present now. And potential resources means that we even haven't find out, or we don't know exactly how much amount it may have. So potential resources are those whose entire quantity may not be known and these are not being used at present. These resources could be used in future. जो अभी तक हमने शायद डिस्कवर भी नहीं किया और लेकिन वो एनर्जी के रूप में बाद में लेटर ऑन यूज हो सकता है, उनको पोटेंशियल रिसोर्सेस कहते हैं. सो लेट्स गो फॉर द क्वेश्चन आंसर. 6-6 हो गए. ओके नेक्स्ट आई विल जस्ट हियर द इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ लैंड ड्यू टू डेजर्टिफिकेशन प्रोसेस इज डैश. सो लॉस, इंक्रीज, बैलेंस होता है या इरेगुलर होता है. द इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्टिविटी ऑफ लैंड ड्यू टू डेजर्टिफिकेशन प्रोसेस इज लॉस, इंक्रीज, बैलेंस और इरेगुलर. यस, वेरी गुड. ए इज द आंसर, दैट इज लॉस. So I will move just if one more question I may take here. Okay, which one of the following organism is first to colonize a bar rock? A. Mosasis. B. Leeches. C. Perennial plants. D. Hydrologic cycle. May I repeat the question? Which one of the following organism is the first colonize a bar rock? Which one of the following organism is the first to colonize a bar rock? A is mosasis, lichens, C is perennial plant, D hydrologic cycle. So correct answer is lichens, L-I-C-H-E-N-S. Very good. So I will move to the last chapter here. Okay, I have covered natural resources also. So let's move to our history topic. So we can move on history slide. Next, I think we can move on next on history topic. Okay. Yes, we shall move on history. We have geography also, history, civic geography. Let's cover that within our, yes, Indian history. So let's move to how is history known to us? You know, 6, 7, 8, three types of history is given. Each year they have sources of history is the same part, but the time span of fifth, sixth class is different, seventh class is different, eighth class is different. Please go through, make a table and learn that. It's very, very easy to learn. Now, importance of history, yes, history is science itself. Let's move to the direct question and answer of this topic. The founder of the Archaeological Survey of India is Cunningham, B. Pliny, D. Herodotus, D. Aristotle. Very good. Correct answer is A only, Cunningham. Next question is, the period about which there is no written evidence is called prehistory, protohistory, history, and the modern period. No, ma'am, this is for paper 2 only. Paper 2, 6, 7, 8, sources of history. We have special chapters on this. It may come, kyunki jo paper 1 ke teachers, agar pass ho jate TET paper 1, they have chances ki unko jab hum recruit karte hain, to 7th class tak wo padha sakte hain for paper 1. So, you know, for yourself, you can have that. Lekin unhone bola hai state board mein ki paper 1 ke liye 1 to 5 class books refer karo. Lekin 6, 7, 8 ke aap padke rakhe hain to koi problem nahi hai. Same things is, yahan pe bhi bola hai paper 2 mein 6, 7, 8 ko padhne ko bola hai. Lekin agar hum 9, 10 ke bhi padke rakhe, apna ko time milne ke baad, pehle go through this, यू नो योर क्लास टेक्स्ट बुक्स जो बोला गया 6-7 days टाइम लेके बाद 9-10 के बुक रेफर करने हैं. जस्ट गो थ्रू द टॉपिक्स, डोंट डीप लर्न फॉर 9th and 10th फॉर पेपर टू. एंड आई विल सजेस्ट सेम थिंग फॉर पेपर वन, गो थ्रू 1 to 5th टेक्स्ट बुक्स डीपली एंड देन इफ यू हैव टाइम गो थ्रू 6, 7, 8. ओके नेक्स्ट आई थिंक आई वॉज गोइंग थ्रू दिस क्वेश्चन. द पीरियड अबाउट विच देर इज नो रिटन एविडेंस इज कॉल्ड ए प्री हिस्ट्री, बी प्रोटो हिस्ट्री, सी हिस्ट्री, डी मॉडर्न पीरियड. सो आंसर इज हियर इज ए प्री हिस्ट्री इफ यू कैन इफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी आंसर्ड. Okay, I would like to give one last question from this. In the context of studying the past manuscripts as important material for historical reconstruction are rather difficult to use because, please listen carefully all options. A option is, I will repeat the question here, in context of studying the past manuscripts as important material for historical reconstruction are rather difficult to use, are rather difficult to use because A, they provide a great deal of detailed information to be precisely used by historians. B, they are often found in monastic or temple repositories away from public access. C, these documents frequently provide multiple versions of the same text. And D, writings in these documents are often an archaic nature and difficult to read. So the question was here, the contents of studying the past manuscripts are important material for historical reconstructor. Important hai, lekin bahut difficult hai. Toh kyun hai aisa? Toh answer is here is C option. Ki unhone kya question pucha hai ki hum wo important hai हमारे लिए मटेरियल पास में जो भी मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट आए हैं, लेकिन उनको रिकंस्ट्रक्ट करना डिफिकल्ट है क्योंकि द आंसर इज आई विल टेल यू द सी ऑप्शन डायरेक्टली मैं पढ़ के बता देती हूँ. दीज डॉक्यूमेंट्स फ्रीक्वेंटली प्रोवाइड मल्टीपल वर्जन्स ऑफ द सेम टेक्स्ट. मतलब मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट दिया हुआ है लेकिन बार बार वही चीजें हमें रिपीटेड मिलती रहती है अलग अलग जगह पे सेम थिंग. इसलिए हम किस चीज को, ये वाले को सच माने या वो वाले को सच माने, दैट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू रिस्ट्रक्चर. नेक्स्ट आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज, आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस क्वेश्चन. सो लाइक दिस यू नो डिस्क्रिप्टिव क्वेश्चन मेक अ, सो गो थ्रू यू नो फर्स्ट थ्री चैप्टर्स आर ऑन दिस हिस्ट्री ओनली, सोर्सेस ऑफ हिस्ट्री. नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज ऑल्सो सेम फॉर 6, 7, 8. So medieval time, like modern time, 8th we have modern time. So go through the chapter. I will post the links for you for direct download the PDF from that link. And madam and sir, I request you, mobile mein download nahi hoga, aapko PC pe jaake wo wale link se download karna padega. I have tried for mobile, lekin mobile mein nahi hota. Aapko ya to PC mein download karna padega ya लैपटॉप पे डाउनलोड करने का पड़ेगा. एक बार डाउनलोड हो गया तो यू कैन व्हाट्सएप ईच अदर पीडीएफ. नेक्स्ट सेकंड चैप्टर है ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट फ्रॉम अर्ली सोसाइटी टू सिटी. सो सेम थिंग हियर, वी हैव वेरी डिफरेंट नेम्स, हरप्पा संस्कृति, मोहनजोदड़ो, then Lothal, Kalibanga. We have to go through this and read their time period, their structure, their costumes. I will go through the questions here. First question from this chapter is, why did the hunter and food gatherers move from one place to another? A, in search of food. B, in search of fodder. C, due to change in climate. All of the above. यहाँ से वहां क्यों मैन घूमता रहा? यस द करेक्ट आंसर इज डी, हर चीज के लिए. इन सर्च ऑफ गुड, इन सर्च ऑफ फॉर्डर, इन ड्यू टू चेंज इन क्लाइमेट. खूब बहुत बारिश होती थी तो वो जगह छोड़ देते, पानी खत्म हो गया वो जगह छोड़ देते थे. तो आंसर इज ऑल ऑफ द अबाउट, डी ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट आंसर. Okay. I want you to write the direct यहाँ पे match the following है. मैं आपको direct answers दे रही हूँ. आप please लिख लिए notebook में अगर आपके पास होगा. तो first option is match the following का gold है. आप वहां पे direct अफगानिस्तान लिखिए. gold gold का लिखिए अफगानिस्तान. gold का लिखिए अफगानिस्तान. copper का लिखिए आप खेतरी KHETRI खेतरी. शेल SHELL शेल का आंसर लिखिए आप. सौराष्ट्र SAURASHTRA. एंड सिल्वर का लिखिए आप ईरान. This is the match the following. उन्होंने आपको ABCD करके वो matches अलग अलग दिए लेकिन मैं आपको direct answer दे रही हूँ यहाँ पे. Same match the following आपको इस lesson से या कोई भी lesson से आ सकता है. तो आपको ऐसा नहीं है कि एक ही topic कर लिया आप. अगर उसके सब topic से चार तो आप चारों learn कीजिए, चारों figures learn कीजिए, तो आपको match the following करने में आसानी रहेगी. So here is the last question. The application of essential principles of modern engineering in hyper cities is mostly characteristically evident from the practice of A. Layout of many these cities in two or more parts. B. Channelizing of water into great bath and drainage of used of water from it. C is building of one or two story high homes with rooms around a courtyard. D, layer of bricks in the interlocking pattern while building walls. Question है यहाँ पे the application of essential principles of modern engineering. मतलब ये 8th class का question है. The application of essential principles of modern engineering in Harappan cities is most characteristically evident from the practice of. Yes. मैं आंसर बता रही हूँ आपको. लास्ट आंसर है लेइंग ब्रिक्स इन एन इंटरलॉकिंग पैटर्न व्हाइल बिल्डिंग वॉल्स. आप डायरेक्ट आंसर लिख सकते हैं. हरप्पन सिटीज लिखिए डैश लिखिए लेइंग ऑफ ब्रिक्स इन एन इंटरलॉकिंग पैटर्न व्हाइल बिल्डिंग वॉल्स. आप ऐसा आंसर लिख दीजिए वहां पे. वन ऑफ द पॉसिबल रीजन फॉर द एब्सेंस ऑफ पॉम्पस बिल्डिंग इन द हरप्पन सिटीज वॉल्स. मैं डायरेक्ट आंसर बता रही हूँ आपको. पहले का भी आंसर आप लिख लीजिए कि हरप्पन सिटीज में कैसे ब्रिक्स रखते थे कि लेइंग ब्रिक्स इन इंटरलॉकिंग. ओके. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन का भी यही आंसर है. सॉरी दूसरा मतलब मैं क्वेश्चन आपको बता देती हूँ एक बार. वन ऑफ द पॉसिबल रीजन फॉर द एब्सेंस ऑफ पॉम्पस बिल्डिंग्स इन हरप्पन सिटी क्या कारण होगा. लो लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड्स ऑफ हरप्पन पीपल. एब्सेंस ऑफ क्लास डिस्टिंक्शन इन हरप्पन सोसाइटी. सी एब्सेंस ऑफ मोनार्कियल सिस्टम्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. D scarcity of requisite material necessary for the construction. तो उनका C option correct है. यहाँ पे absence of monarchical system of the government. चलिए हम third chapter की तरफ बढ़ रहे हैं. वैदिक period. वैदिक period में आ जाता है आपका tribes of Aryan. वेदा उपवेदा ब्रह्मणा आपके स्क्रिप्चर्स आ जाएंगे. महाभारत रामायणा आपका पीरियड आएगा. ऋग्वेद पीरियड. पॉलिटिकल लाइफ ऑफ ईच पीरियड. वैदिक पीरियड. मैथलेकिक पीरियड. चलिए हम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स की तरफ बढ़ रहे हैं. अभिषेक सर आई थिंक आवाज आ रही है.
यस मैम इट्स क्लियर.
ओके. So we have a, again light shut down here, but let's move. Yes. Can I have the match the following question again from this? एक मैं आपको question बता देती हूँ ताकि आप direct answer लिख सके. तो अब अगर आप लिख रहे हैं तो note down कर रहे हैं तो लिख लीजिए. संस्कृत. So what is the? I will read it, then I will answer it. Okay. Please don't write the answer. Just I am reading here. सेक्शन ए में उन्होंने लिखा है संस्कृत लैंग्वेज ऑफ ईस्टर्न रीजन, मलयालम लैंग्वेज ऑफ सेंट्रल इंडिया. अभी हमको उसका इससे जोड़ना है फैमिलीज से. सो यहाँ पे बी सेक्शन में इंडो यूरोपियन लैंग्वेज फैमिली, तिब्बत बर्मा लैंग्वेज फैमिली, द्रविडियन लैंग्वेज फैमिली, फोर ऑस्ट्रो एस्टिक लैंग्वेज फैमिली. तो करेक्ट आंसर मैं आपको बता देती हूँ डायरेक्टली. So Sanskrit goes to Indo-European language family. Okay, so Sanskrit is just write Sanskrit Indo-European language family. Language of eastern region is Tibet Burma language family. Malayalam is Dravidian language family. एंड डी ऑप्शन जो था लैंग्वेज ऑफ सेंट्रल इंडिया वो है ऑस्ट्रो एस्टिक एशियाटिक ASIATIC एशियाटिक लैंग्वेज फैमिली. सी हियर व्हाट इज द गैम्बल हियर. उन्होंने करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन के सामने लिखे हैं. सेम ए का वन ही है, बी का टू है, सी का थ्री है और डी का फोर है. सामने सामने क्वेश्चन आंसर लिखे है. आप कंफ्यूज, आपको आंसर में क्या लिखा है वो पढ़ना है और तभी आप मैच द फॉलोइंग करेंगे. तो इस तरह से वो लोग कंफ्यूज करेंगे आप लोगों को. डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स अवर नेक्स्ट लेसन राइज ऑफ स्टेट्स महाजनपदा. लेट्स गो टू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. कैपिटल ऑफ मत्स्य जनपदा वॉज डैश ए चंपा, बी विराटनगर, सी कुशीनारा, डी गोकुलपारा. द कैपिटल ऑफ मत्स्य जनपदा. सी स्टेट्स नेम एंड प्लेस नेम आर ऑल्सो डिफरेंट इन डिफरेंट मिडिवियल पीरियड्स. सो वी हैव टू गो थ्रू दैट ऑल्सो. So the answer is, I will repeat the question here. The capital of Matsya Janpada was B. Answer is Viratnagar. Now, the battle of Jhelum was fought between Porus and Alexander A, B, Ashoka and Alexander B, C, Bindusara and Alexander D, none of the above. The battle of Jhelum. I will repeat. Battle of Jhelum was fought between Porus and Alexander, Ashoka and Alexander, Bindusara and Alexander, and D, none of the above. The correct answer is Porus and Alexander, option A. Next, our next lesson is emergence of new ideas, Buddhism and Jainism. तो आपको left hand side पे Buddhism and right hand side पे Jainism ऐसे topic लिख के आराम से आप textbook पे full lesson आपका वही है. तो वहां से just आपको point निकालने हैं और लिखने हैं हाथ से. Please written exam की written तैयारी करें. Don't go for oral. ओरल पढ़ने से शायद आपकी लॉन्ग टर्म मेमोरी में जाएगा नहीं. सो फॉर मेकिंग इट लॉन्ग टर्म मेमोरी राइट द आंसर्स. सो आई विल गो थ्रू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स हियर. यू हैव टू गो थ्रू टीचिंग ऑफ बुद्धिज्म, टीचिंग ऑफ जैनिज्म. आई हैव विजिटेड राजस्थान एंड गुजरात. सो यू नो वो और भी ज्यादा अच्छे से लर्न हो गए. व्हेन वी विजिट द प्लेसेस वी लर्न मोर. सो लेट्स go through the question answers here. The correct statement about the teaching of Zoroaster and Iranian prophet is A. The original compilation of the teachings of Zoroaster is found in the Zendavesta. B. The concept of original teaching of Zoroaster is good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. Now, how are the options here? Option A option is correct, B is incorrect. B option is both A and B are correct. C says A is incorrect, B is correct, and both A, B are incorrect. So like this, they will give two statements from the lesson and you have to see that you have read that statement. So go through test books. I am writing, I am repeating again and again. Go through history, civic, geography textbooks also. So A option was the origin compilation of the teachings of Zoroaster is found in Zendavesta. So you should know whether it is correct or not. And B option is the concept of original teaching of Zoroaster is good thoughts, good words, and good deeds. So this also you should know the statement whether it is correct or not. So both options are correct here. Thank you who have given this answer. Your answer is correct. Both options are correct here. Next question is, the most striking way in which the rising heterodox faiths like Jainism and Buddhism differed from the later Vedic view of life was in relation to A, law of karma, B, doctrine of rebirth, C, faith in self-purification, D, belief in the God. May I repeat the question? The most striking way in which the rising heterodox faiths like Jainism and Buddhism differ from the later Vedic view of life was in relation to law of karma, doctrine of rebirth, the faith in the self-purification, the belief in God. Yes. The belief in God, last option is correct. In one of the inscriptions, Ashoka proclaimed, work I do and work I must, yet I am not satisfied. The said statement shows that Ashoka, here his statement is given and you have to understand what concept has been laid here. So I will repeat the question here. In one of his inscripts, Ashoka proclaimed, what work I do and work I must, yet I am not satisfied. The said statement shows Ashoka was not satisfied with the progress made by Buddhism under his patronage. B option is desired his officials to emulate his noble examples of serving the people. C, he wanted to extol his image in the eyes of contemporary kings and his subjects. D option is was genuinely committed to the serving the people relentlessly. Work I do, work I must, yet I am not satisfied. The B option is correct here. The desired his officials to emulate his noble examples of serving the people. This option is correct one. So like, if any statement is given, you have to understand that statement also. We are at still sixth topic, Mayurian Empire, the first empire. I will go through one question only from this topic. So you have to write the Mayurian officials, then Indo-Greek. Topics are much bigger, but you have to go through their time, their ears. So let's do one question from this. Who is not associated with medicine? A, Dhanvantari, B, Bhaskaracharya, C, Chakra, and D, Sushruta. I think easy one is this. Bhaskaracharya, yes. Dhanvantri, Chakra, and Sushruta, we have rhymes and hymns about Ayurveda we learn in Sanskrit also. So Bhaskaracharya is the answer. Bhaskaracharya is the great man who is not associated with medicine. Now, who was the founder of Mauryan Empire? A. Ashoka, Bindusara, Chandragupta, Pushyamitra. Who was the founder of Mauryan Empire? Yes, correct answer is C. Chandragupta. Now, next is the Gupta Empire Golden Age. So again, you know, in history, we are fed up of their eras, but we have to learn to go through it, write down their ages, write down their practice, what they make, what the statements they make. Let's have one question from this chapter. Okay, I will go through one match the following here in from this chapter. I will just read out first, then I will answer. I will just read out here. A, column A, Amar Singh, Varahamihar, Dhanvantari, Kalidasa. B option is lexicographer, astronomer, physician, and D writer. So I will just answer this question. What is the answer, correct answer? So you can write it down. Amar Singh is lexicographer, Varaha Mihira is astronomer, Dhanvantari is physician, and Kalidasa is writer. Okay. Next chapter, Rajput period, emergence of new dynasties. Again, this chapter is, you know, our time. We have just visited. If we go to place now, we learn many things. So we'll have let's have one question from this chapter. In India, which empire ruled Kannauj in Middle Ages? A. Radhar. Gurjar Pratihara Chauhan Pala. In India, which empire ruled Kannauj in Middle Ages? Rathor, Gurjar Parihara, Chauhan Pala. Yes, B option is correct. Very good. Thank you, everyone. Let's have next question. We have to go for geography also. Geography is also have many things. Rise of Delhi Sultanate. I think we should move to our civics now. So go through please chapters like this and you will find the question answer related in textbook only. So we will go for civics now. We have 6-10 minutes and then we will go 20 minutes for geography. Sir, we can have a next slide for civics. Yes. Diversity. First chapter we have diversity. What is the meaning of diversity? It means having geographical, cultural, linguistic, clothing, or religious differences living in untidily in a country. Now we have again communism, prejudice, stereotypy, inequality, untouchability. These things we have to learn through these chapters. So let's go for. We have to learn state and their capitals also, okay? So please go through our state and capitals. It may come new states and new capitals have formed. Please go through Now, next, first question I will have from this is, the state having the shortest coastline is, in India, the state having the shortest coastline is Goa, Odisha, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh. A, Goa, B, Odisha, C, Kerala, D, Andhra Pradesh. Shortest coastline. Yes, very good. Goa have the shortest coastline. So next, I will move for the next chapter, government. So government, level of government, function of government, types and forms of government, right to vote, basic elementary elements of democracy. We have a constitutional aspect of local government and development of local government. Now, Gram Sabha, Gram Panchayat, administration of urban centers. We have chapters on it. We have just to read the text. We have just go through the chapters, okay? You will come to know about it. Now, we will have one question from here. The minimum age limit for the membership of Gram Panchayat is? See, such questions you will get in textbook only when you read the chapter. Okay, you have answered already. Let me give options here. The minimum age of limit for membership of Gram Panchayat is 18 years, B, 21 years, 25 years, and 30 years. What is the minimum age? It's 21 years. Okay, 21 year, B option is correct. Minimum age limit for membership of Gram Panchayat. So go through the chapter, please. Now, I will have one question. Constitutional government means? Constitutional government means A, government according to the terms of constitution. B, government based on rule of law. C, democratic government. All of this. D option. So, all of the above. Very good. Now, last question from this. Democratic government in our times are usually referred to as A, people's democracy, B, participatory democracy, D, representative democracy, D, parliamentary democracy. What do we mean by democratic government? Representative democracy. Okay, we have representative democracy. So next chapter, equality in Indian democracy and state government. Go through the topics, please. I will ask one question. The Indian Constitution recognizes that citizens are equal in terms of their A, legal status, cultural status, economic status, social status. Yes, the option is legal status. Now, here comes our gender topic. This is very important. One question may be asked here. Let's have that one question just as a practice. Which of the following statement is correct? A, all societies hold the same views, similarity. Similarly, about the roles that the boys and girls play. B, our society does not differentiate between boys and girls when they are growing up. C, the work that women do at home is valued as much as what men do outside home. D, caregiving work is not a part of larger system of social inequality. Which statement is correct one? So I will give the correct answer here. A option was correct. All societies hold the same view similarly about the roles that the boys and girls play. They both have same views. Now, next question, next lesson is media and advertisement. So communication, medium of technique, media and democracy, how they help each other. and how me, what is the meaning of advertisement, what is the meaning of democracy related to the media. We have to go through these topics. One question from this: the scrutiny of which type of content is not a part of censorship of TV programs? A. Interest of political parties. B. Vulgarity and violence. C. National integration. D. Communal harmony. Which is not part of censorship of TV programs? Interest of political parties. They don't censor. Okay. So here the option was A only. Indian Constitution and secularism. So we live day-to-day life based on this fundamental rights, right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to religion, educational and cultural right, right to constitutional remedies. So in this chapter, we have to learn about our rights. So in next chapter is Parliament and Judiciary. I'm not asking question. I'm just discussing the topics, subtopics of the topics. This chapter has Parliament and Parliament role, Judiciary roles, which we have for Lok Sabha, for Rajya Sabha. Next topic is marginalization, social justice, livelihood, economic field, and government. So what is tribal life we have from government side, because they can't speak, they are not educated, government have many schemes for them. So we can study about this in this chapter or in these subtopics. So I will have one question from this chapter. Which of the following is not a common means of livelihood in traditional villages? A. Services. B. Fishing. C. Farming. D. Weaving. Which of the following is not a common means of livelihood in traditional villages? A. Services. B. Fishing. C. Farming. D. Weaving. So services is not the livelihood in traditional villages. A. Services is the answer. Now, we will start with geography. We have just 15 minutes left. I want to give PDFs also. Let's complete geography first. We will, yes, sir. Abhishek, sir, we can move to next slide. Yes, geography. The Earth in the solar system. So I have given you one slide also related to this. The number of days and number of rotation, number of rings, number of satellites each planet have. Please go through that slide also. We can have one question from this chapter. 11 topics are there. Let's discuss first one. First question is, most of the countries adopt their respective standard time from? I am giving the options here. A. Longitude of the country. B. Latitude of the country. C. Central meridian of the country. D. Longitude and latitude both of the country. So most of the countries adopt their respective standard time from? सेंट्रल मेरिडियन. ओके, सेंट्रल मेरिडियन जो बीच में होता है पूरे जो देश के बीच में से जाती है वो ज्यादातर वही मेरिडियन रखते हैं हम. ओके, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मैप्स. टाइप्स ऑफ मैप्स, कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ मैप, देयर डायरेक्शन वी हैव टू लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर. So I will ask one question from this. By which color is the settlement shown on the map? Red, yellow, green, brown. By which color is the settlement shown on the map? A. Red. B. Yellow. C. Green. D. Brown. So A option is correct. Red color is taken. Okay. Now next topic is internal structure of the earth and changing features. So we have to go through the layers of earth like inner core, outer core, Gutenberg distinctly, asthenosphere, crust. So layers, this is given in our test book. You can go through the test book itself. In chapter also they have given. Now because of this, we have different types of rocks buried at different layers. We have to learn the types of rocks also here. Now how we come to know about this layers? Earthquakes. So we have to go through earthquake topic also. So what are the forces of earth which makes earthquakes endogenic, exogenic? So waves we have to learn it. Once earthquake is there, we know mountains are built, some goes away. So we have to learn through what are plateaus, landslide, mountains, subtopics came up obviously. So let's have one question from this. The core of the earth is dash, solid, liquid, gaseous, plasma. The core of the earth is dash, solid, liquid, gaseous, plasma. Yes, solid. Core of the earth is solid. Very good. Now, next question. An important mountain range of Europe is? An important mountain range of Europe is dash. The Andes, the Atlas, the Alps, the Rockies. Thank you, everyone. We are on the same path. The Alps is the answer. Next, we have our topic, major domains of the earth. So what are the major domains of the earth? Lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, biosphere. We have to, each level, each layer, we have to learn about their distance. We have ozone layer also. So such topics we have to do. And deep learning is required. So to make long-term memory, I will again say, please write it down, make a map, make a mind map, make a flow chart to learn, but write with pencil. We have one question here. The largest continent of the world. Okay, this is the easiest one. Largest continent of the world is Africa, North America, Asia, Antarctica. Yes, Asia is the correct answer. I will have one more question. The Ural Mountains separate dash. Africa, Europe, North America and South America, Africa, Asia, and last option is Asia and Europe. So which is the answer? The Ural Mountains. B option is the correct, Asia and Europe. Okay, such little things you can learn from this chapter. Next topic is the earth. Air and water. So layers of air I have again given. We will move with the slideshow again for those who have not joined earlier. Let's have one question from this chapter. Which layer of the earth is not most suitable for flying jet aircraft? A, troposphere, B, stratosphere, C, thermosphere, D, exosphere. Which layer of the earth is most suitable for flying jet aircraft? Yes, B answer is correct, stratosphere. Okay, suitable for flying jet aircraft. Next is environment and its resources. Okay, so environment, natural and man-made environment, natural environment. Natural environment, biotic and abiotic. Man-made environment is building, industry, road, bridges, park, culture like that. We have ecosystem, food chain. Again, pyramid of energy is also given here. So science and social study. You know, we can't subdivide here geography mein or here science mein hai. So that's why we say, one book only, environmental studies. in primary. So let's have one question from this chapter. Identify which is incorrect pair. Uttarakhand, Periyar, Maharashtra, Melghat, Karnataka, Bandipur, Assam, Manas. Which is the incorrect pair? If you know this thing, you can answer this. Identify the incorrect pair. Uttarakhand, Periyar, Maharashtra, Melghat, Karnataka, Bandipur, Assam, Manas. So incorrect pair is A option, Uttarakhand and Periyar. Let's have the next chapter, Minerals and Power Resources. Here you have to learn about the place and there which mineral is where. So through this chapter, you can come to know about it. Solar energy, tidal energy, wind energy, biogas, biodiesel, nuclear powers in our India and across abroad also. Next chapter is agriculture and industries. Types of agriculture, cultural rearing, revolutions in agriculture, factors affecting agriculture, types of crops. In industry, we have primary occupation and secondary occupation also. So please go through that. Please go through the classification of industries, factors affecting location of industries, cotton, textile, iron. Seventh and eighth, primary occupation, secondary occupation is there. The chapters are there. Please go through, write it down. Once you write it down, you no need to rhyme it or rote learning it. So we will have one question in raw material required for iron and steel industry are. First, A, iron coal, lime coal. B option is iron coal, lime and steel. C option, iron ore, lime, bauxite. D option, iron ore, steel and coal. What raw materials we need for iron and steel industry? Yes. First option is correct. Iron ore, we need iron ore, we need lime, we need coal. Okay, first option is correct. Next chapter is human environment, settlement, transport, communication, and regional life. So human environment, obviously brain system also. Now transport, we know by air, by water transport, and land transport, we learn about this. Life in deserts, their transportation. So let's have one question from this. Which one of the following is the highest roadway of India in the world? Highest roadway of India in the world. Shillong Silchar, B Udhampur Srinagar, C Itanagar Pasighat, D Manali Leh. Which is the highest roadway of India? Very good. D option is correct, Manali Leh. Next is human resources. Distribution of population subtopics are, I am repeating the subtopics here, human resources. Distribution of population, population density, factors affecting the distribution of population, population change, some terms like birth rate, death rate, sex ratio, immigrants and immigrants, composition of population, their population pyramid they have given, and Indian Census 2011. Let's have one question from it. More than 80% of population of world lives in dash. North America and Asia, Asia and Europe, Asia and Africa, and last option is Asia and South America. A Asia and Africa. Very good. Asia and Africa. And we have the last topic, our country, India. So we have many, you know, location, their extent, the rivers, the plateaus, physical division, everything. Sir, I am Abhishek, sir. We have end our topics, science, history, civics, and geography. I'm just texting you the PDFs of our 6th, 7th, 8th book, science, history, civics, geography book. Please post in chat box.
Yes, ma'am.
Please share the feedback link also.
Should I close the PPT?
Yes, sir. Please close the PPT. So please post the feedback link also. Before leaving, I will request everyone to go to share your feedbacks. How was today's lecture? Yes, sir. I have forwarded you. Just post in the PDF chat box, sir. Thank you everyone for being there until the last moment. Tomorrow I will have the paper discussion of all subjects, child psychology, English, math, science and social study again. Paper one also, paper two also. And I will try to, you know, give the best from my side for your exam preparation. Please go through this textbook, download it from laptop and computer. You can't download it from mobile. I request everyone to download this PDFs from the laptop or computer, please. And I'm very thankful to Abhishek sir, Nayan sir, and Darby Foundation for giving me chance to have this one-to-one talk with student teachers. Sir, please, in the last minute, I will share the teacher talk app where students can join a discussion forum. They can ask the queries on the teacher talk app. आपको जरूर वहाँ पे answer मिलेगा. आपको जो भी परेशानी हो या आपको कुछ पूछना हो या आपको कुछ confusion हो, you can go through teacher talk app. I'm just sharing where, from Play Store. Sir, please share the Google Play Store link of Teacher Talk app also and our feedback link also. I'm sharing the screen now. From Google Play Store, you can download the TCHR Talk. You can spell it. You just click it. This is the logo of Teacher Talk. You have to just log into. You have to sign once. यहाँ पे बहुत सारे फीचर्स है. मैं जैसे आपको चार दिन से बता रही हूँ. आप यहाँ पे आके पॉइंट्स रिगेन कर सकते हैं. वी हैव ऑफर फॉर टीचर्स जहाँ पे आपको पॉइंट्स मिलने के बाद और भी हर चीज सस्ते में पड़ती है. जॉब्स ऑफर है हमारे लिए, टीचर्स के लिए. अगर आप जॉब सर्च कर रही है तो प्लीज गो थ्रू दिस जॉब सर्चिंग. और या फिर आप अपनी अपनी डिग्री और अपना प्लेस का नाम वहां पे पोस्ट कर सकते हैं ताकि हम लोग अगर उस रिलेटेड कुछ हमारे पास इंफॉर्मेशन होगी तो हम जरूर टीचर टॉक ऐप पे हम पोस्ट करेंगे उस जगह पे. हियर इज द डिस्कशन फोरम. यू कैन गो ऑन दिस डिस्कशन फोरम. दीज आर नाउ यू नो दिस वीक्स डिस्कशन फोरम फॉर इंग्लिश. यू कैन क्लिक हियर, सी हियर. So people had addressed us for their queries. We have answered also. Nayan sir is also here. He also gives you answer if he knows it. And everyone is sharing their best to, you know, for our teachers. This app and this Darby Foundation is working for teachers, by the teacher, for the teachers. So please go through these apps. We have we from next week, every Friday we have sessions regarding teachers. Upcoming sessions आपको कल नयन सर आपको announce करेंगे next month की. तो आप जरूर कल के इसमें ज्वाइन कीजिए और आने वाले इवेंट्स को आप सेकंड अगर आप इवेंट्स डालते हैं तो यहाँ पे आपको आने वाले इवेंट्स के बारे में पता लग जाएगा. न्यूज फीड इज फॉर वंस यू हैव साइन अप यू कैन शेयर योर थॉट्स, यू कैन शेयर योर व्यूज, यू कैन शेयर एनीथिंग हियर एंड टीचर विल डिस्कस विद यू. थैंक यू एवरीवन. थैंक यू अभिषेक सर. आई विल जस्ट स्टॉप दिस.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yes,
I have shared all the links for feedback for the app and all the PDF that you have shared with me. All the links have been shared.
Thank you, Abhishek sir. आज पता नहीं क्या exactly 5 o'clock light चली गई थी.
हाँ.
आ रही थी जा रही थी but with the help of you I can accomplish today's session. तो आपकी बहुत मदद रही आज. थैंक यू वेरी मच टू यू. आई विल लीव फ्रॉम एवरीवन. आप जो भी यहाँ पे हैं प्लीज फीडबैक शेयर करें. आपका फीडबैक हमारे लिए बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है. सो आई विल रिक्वेस्ट शेयर योर फीडबैक्स एंड प्लीज ज्वाइन टीचर टॉक ऐप फॉर आवर फर्दर कम्युनिकेशन. टीचर टॉक ऐप पे हम कम्युनिकेट जरूर, वहां पे हम दोनों भी होते हैं, मैं भी होती हूँ, उर्मिला मैम भी होती है. तो हम लोग टीएटी के बारे में अभी क्योंकि डेट फिर से 21 नवंबर को पहुंच गई है तो अगर आपकी क्वेरीज हो, आपकी कंफ्यूजन हो तो आप जरूर वहां पे रखिए और हम लोग आंसर करेंगे. ओवर टू अभिषेक सर नाउ.
यस मैम. थैंक यू सो मच मैम. आपने भी बहुत ही अच्छी तरीके से सब टीचर्स को आप समझाए सारे सब्जेक्ट्स. टीचर्स को बहुत कुछ समझा है. ऑब्वियसली कुछ ना कुछ तो रह ही क्या रहेगा तो दे कैन पोस्ट ऑन टीचर टॉक ऐप उसके लिए. एंड टीचर आप शिल्पा मैम आपका भी बहुत ही धन्यवाद. आपने बहुत अच्छी तरीके से सारे कंटेंट बनाया, पीडीएफ बनाया. एसआर डलवी फाउंडेशन से बहुत बड़ा थैंक्स आपको.
Thank you, sir. We have this recording on FB also. We will share on YouTube also. वहाँ से भी आप लोग slides का screenshot ले पाएंगे. Thank you, everyone. I am taking your leave with your permission. Thank you, everyone.
We will be on for 5 minutes, so you can download all the PDF, all the links you want to copy paste. By 7:07, we will be stopping the meeting.
Okay, thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Those who want to download that PDF link, at least just copy and paste in your WhatsApp link. Afterwards, you can download it from your laptop and computer. Thank you very much.